Hello and welcome to this week's UK Dispatch. Now on the show today, we're going to be meeting the undisputed leaders of the Gothic movement. That's the Sisters of Mercy and The Mission. Now Wayne Hussey used to belong to the Sisters of Mercy, and then the band split up, he formed The Mission, and Andrew Eldritch teamed up with Patricia Morrison and kept the same name, the Sisters of Mercy. So here is the original lineup with a song called Walk Away.
And in the summer when the clouds come through, I might go the same way to it, and I could talk together. Well, what am I supposed to do with you? And I would walk together then.
Obviously, The Mission was born of Sisters of Mercy. What were your views on how the split occurred?
Oh, goodness.
It was inevitable. It really hinged on when and where it was going to happen. But we knew it was going to happen at some point. And there was a bust up, and we went our separate ways.
Mm. But was it quite acrimonious? I mean, Andrew Eldritch would probably suggest that it was.
Well, I think any relationship, when it ends, initially, there's always a feeling of bitterness and resentment. And I think, yeah, at the time there was. I don't feel any of that anymore.
Mm.
It's 2.5 years since I was in the same room with him.
Really, that long?
Mm.
So what about all this business about the names that you were originally going to call it? Sisterhood or?
Yeah, well, we were put in a situation where really we had our backs up against the wall and we couldn't do anything, so the only way out of that was to antagonise. So that was part of the strategy.
What, you had your backs up against the wall
Leaving? Pardon?
Re-leaving, that it was a problem?
Yeah, well, we couldn't make records, we couldn't go on tour, we didn't have any money. Record company wouldn't release us. It wouldn't, you know, let us do anything. So we figured just make life difficult for them. In the end, they let us go.
Do you find it peculiar now you're both back in the charts at the same time?
It is quite a nice feeling, actually. I was hoping that Andrew would be doing Top of the Pops with us today, but he's not.
What would you have said to him if you haven't spoken to him for 2.5 years?
I'm not sure. Probably, hello. And taking it from there.
Those who us in part-time lovers, as baby moves,
get on this line. We'll smoke and fire and steel and wire and glass and spire and doors on the floor and dome with legs torn and drawn. Sleepless nights are spent with angels heaven sent. Stay with me, lay with me.
Sisters of Mercy split up. I mean, Gothic fans do tend to be quite a loyal bunch. Did they come with you? Did they stay with the Sisters of Mercy?
Well, I think it's a bit of both. I think initially a lot of them came with us and also went with Andrew. I mean, I don't think it really boils down to that. I think it's very likely that a lot of them like both of us. I don't know, obviously there's going to be a division somewhere.
But it must have been quite tricky, you starting out on your own and wondering if everyone would be really peeved about the fact that you'd split up the Sisters of Mercy.
Well, that wasn't really a consideration, it was just something we wanted to do. I mean, it wasn't like, you know, you didn't sit down and think, well, we split the sisters up, what can we do now? Mm. I mean, I fell into the job of singing, I was a victim of circumstance in that respect. It just so happened that I had a better voice than Craig.
Is that the case?
Yeah.
God, that seems to have done too bad now, isn't it?
No, I'm getting better.
From my window, and I can see the years to come. I live for the burn and the sting of pleasure. I live for the sword, the stealing of gun.
Now, I know you've recently completed a tour in America. In fact, just come back today. Was it a pretty grueling experience for you?
The flight back was. The tour itself wasn't. It was quite a good fun, actually. It was a lot more fun than the last American tour. But then this one was only quite short. But it was good.
I remember reading somewhere that Craig came home during the last American tour. What was all that about?
Well, he just flipped out, really. It all got a bit too much for him. He cracked, so we sent him home to have a haircut and a rest.
So what did you do when you were playing live?
We got one of the roadies to stand in.
Really?
He did a remarkable job.
Oh, God, was Craig a bit worried?
No, not really. I think he knew his job was safe.
And what was all this about, a pledge for you to give up illicit substances and drink, etc.?
Yeah. I've given up drugs, but I still drink. On the odd occasion.
The Mission's latest single, Tower of Strength, comes from their new album, which is called Children. And that was produced by the former Led Zeppelin bassist, John Paul Jones. Children, how does it differ from God's Own Medicine, would you say?
I'll let Simon answer this. I've been all talking.
Different cover.
It's got a different cover. Oh, God.
Yeah, there's a lot more to it than that. All the songs are different. And
I think it's a more mature LP. It's more of a band LP.
More mature LP.
We spent a lot longer making it first out.
What about the lyrics? Are they of a more personal note?
I think they're a lot more... I think lyrics have always been quite personal, but I think they're a lot more defined this time. I think the first LP, they were a little confused. You know, it was a new area for me. I was like finding my way.
Now, quite an appropriate title for the LP, Children. Given the birth of your baby, Hannah, how has it changed your life?
Drastically. I mean, it's affected me a whole lot more than I ever anticipated doing so. But, it shifts all your priorities around.
Do you feel much more of a responsible person?
Not essentially, no. I mean, I don't think responsibility comes into it because it's a pleasure. But there are other considerations now that maybe weren't there before.
How are you planning to bring her up then?
I don't think you can really plan to do something like that.
You must have some ideas about
it. Well, it's the best that I can. You know, that's all I can do. I mean, it's new to me. So, you know, I learn as I go along. I'll make mistakes.
Unfortunately, Andrew Eldritch and Patricia Morrison, the current Sisters of Mercy lineup, hadn't just flown back from the States, so they were a little more lively, although only just.
Now, the current lineup of Sisters of Mercy has obviously changed quite a bit, and obviously a lot of things were said about the split being quite acrimonious. Was this true?
It started off very amicably. Mm. There were very good reasons for the band in its former state to dissolve that everybody was very happy with. It was only after that that there was some dissent about who should be called what, and then it got sort of strange. That was when I got to meet a lot of lawyers.
Mm.
People keep sending me their lawyers, and I don't really get on very well with other people's lawyers. Luckily, I get on fine with my own. So.
They tried to call themselves Sister of Mercy, did they?
They did.
Mm-hmm.
They did.
But even the mission is a derivation of a song, isn't it?
Yeah, the next Sisters album was going to be called Left on Mission and Revenge. I suppose the thread which was to link the album was a street map of San Francisco, like a chessboard. It's the thread which links Alice to the Looking Glass.
Mm. Now, after the dissolution, there were a couple of rumours about you being dead or just disappearing and all this sort of thing. What actually happened?
I want a way to put some weight on.
Had you been ill?
Yeah. We'd done a lot of touring, and I was a shadow of my former self by that time.
And then Patricia stepped in. What do you do to improve matters with Andrew?
I also at that same time was in the same situation that he was as far as health-wise, although since I am a much bigger girl, I was in much better shape, but it was time to change and time to move on. And we work well together and are quite good for each other as far as that health situation.
Patricia stops me doing all those things that musicians like to do, which are very, very bad for you.
Mm-hmm. I was trying to say it very politely.
Now, on this corrosion, you employed the talents of old Jim Steinman, who's probably better known for his work with Meatloaf.
Well, not now.
Now he's got even something else to live.
Now he's going to have to make another album with Meatloaf, which I think he's about to do in order to top what he's just done.
Was it his idea to get in the 40-strong choir on this corrosion?
No, it was our idea. He was the only person that would go along with it, which is why he did the project.
And didn't you multi-track it over and over again?
Yes, there's an awful lot of voices on that record.
Mm. Were you pleased with how that leapt up the chart?
It was very gratifying.
Yeah. Yes. How important is the charts to you?
Not very. But, I mean, if you have chart success, I think it's worth enjoying it while it lasts. We did a kiss and talk. We did something that I missed. Give me the pain, a pain to hold. Wild and what it seems. Give me the kill the king when love is the law. And the wheel turn round. Give me the rain, say. Dream child, and do you hear it all?
Living on a hip and tried to write somebody, but a simple me.
Patricia, how have you affected sort of a change in direction musically for Sisters of Mercy? I mean, do you think there even has been one?
No, I don't think there's been much of a change in the direction of music. It's strongly going in the direction it should be going, and there's been no direct change, no contrivance with me joining the group. The songs are our number one priority, and that's one reason why there's only two of us, because if we don't want a guitar part now, we don't have to have a guitar part. But the music has not been, the songwriting, I don't think has been affected. There's been no change in the style, just a maturing, of course, and a natural progression.
Do you not miss working with a group of people? I know there can be a lot of troubles with that, but also it can probably be quite a positive experience sometimes.
It's nice to have done it. It's also very nice not to have to do it anymore.
Exactly.
Now, the single Dominion seems to be about the march towards humans' self-destruction. Is that actually how you both feel?
It's more about monuments and how futile they are, and the sort of people that build them.
Is that why you?
And how silly they look when they're built and the people are gone.
And people are gone. Is that why you shot the video in Jordan?
It has an awesome monument.
Mm-hmm.
Has a cave city which used to be inhabited by 40,000 people who are all gone.
How long were you out there to shoot the video?
Just 2 days.
Oh, so you didn't get to see much of the Middle East then?
No, but we landed at Amman and then drove down to Petra, so we saw most of Jordan.
Self-admitted pessimist.
Realist. I know, a pragmatist.
I mean, are you happy with that description of yourself? Is it true? I mean, you actually seem to thrive on the image of being, you know, doom and gloom.
No, I think that's appalling. I'd hate to think our records have that effect on people.
Well, I mean, I think there might be a case for suggesting that some people might be put off by your image, even though your music, I mean, I personally think it's rather wonderful, but you might risk alienating a lot of people because of the image.
What if we were to wear white?
Which you have done in the video.
Yes.
Just to prove that we can alienate people in white as
yes.
well.
We're yeah. the same people, we're playing the same music, we're just in a little different colour.
Even though the two groups don't actually communicate with each other, it seems that the fans have got two bands now for the price of one. And for old time's sake, let's see the two opposing camps together for the last time with No Time to Cry from 1984.